Research data encompasses a much broader range of things that we normally think of. So when I say to you research data for a project, for a dissertation project, you might think of perhaps survey data or interview transcripts or perhaps readings from an instrument that you have in a lab. But actually, all of us will produce data no matter what project we have. So even those of you who are doing theoretical work will produce data in the form of notes. But also those of you who are taking a trip and maybe doing fieldwork will also produce data. Now, the important thing to remember about data is that if you don't think carefully about the kind of data you will produce and the type and amount of data you will produce in your dissertation, it is likely that your dissertation will look a bit like a junk drawer. And this is something I tell my students a lot. So imagine that drawer in your house that perhaps you have where you put everything you don't know what to do with. So maybe you end up with paper clips, with random receipts, with pens, paper, scissors, glue, I don't know, anything that you don't know what to do with, you just shove it in there. And this is what can happen really easily with your dissertation. So imagine that you take that drawer, you empty it on the ground, and then you start looking at everything you have. And you probably end up finding things you didn't even know you had. And so the reason we're doing this course is to try and help you avoid ending up with a dissertation that looks like your junk drawer in your house.